Hey guys, welcome back to Uni Voyage. This is Manya Gupta from IIM Rohtak, and today we will be busting some myths about the ITMAT exam. So for every aspirant, the two most important things are A, to study and prepare obviously, and B, to stay clear of all the false information that is out there. So let's clear the air around. Myth number one, non-math students cannot crack ITMAT. Well, this information is absolutely false. In my batch itself, there are so many students who did not have math in the 11th and 12th grade. The exam does have a section of quantitative ability, but if you study for it well, you'll surely be able to crack it. The institute does not differentiate between a math and a non-math student. Myth number two, IPM is not a good course for the science students. Well, if you're a science student, first thing you need to have clarity about what you want to do. Say if you want to pursue engineering, then IPM is not a good course for you. But if you wish to get into the field of management, then it is surely one of the best choices that you have. Anyway, the IPM course is so diverse. It is not restricted to a particular field. We have subjects like sociology, law, programming, calculus, accounting, economics, all in just one course. Moreover, 35-40% of the students of my batch were previously from the science stream. Myth number three, you do not get a BA or a BBA degree in the IPM course. So the IPM Indore course is a BA plus MBA program, and the IPM Rohtak, Ranchi, Jammu and Bodh Gaya is a BBA plus MBA program. After the completion of the first 3 years of the course, you do get a BA or a BBA degree depending upon the institute you completed from. This false information that you do not get one is out there because earlier IIMs were not allowed to give out degrees. IGNOU was responsible for that, but after the enactment of the IIM Act, IIMs are allowed to do so. So you do get a degree. Myth number four, droppers do not get into the course. This information is not true. So many of my friends from college are actually droppers. In fact, I know one or two people who took a double drop, which is a drop for 2 years in a row, and still made it here. So it is just that you should be able to justify the reason of your drop to the interviewers in case they question you, which they will most probably. So don't just say that you wanted to relax or chill or enjoy life or explore the meaning of life and things like that. Do have a good solid reason to back you. Myth number five, you need to start preparing for ITMAT a year or two in advance. Well, this definitely is a myth, because if it was true, I for sure would not have been a part of this course. I started my preparation after my class 12 board exams, and I did not take a drop, so I did not have years to prepare, but whatever time I had, I made full use of that. I enrolled myself into a crash course and studied with full dedication, and thankfully it was enough and I am here now. So even if you have a few months in your hand, you can definitely crack the exam. Also, if you're looking for a nice ITMAT coaching, we at Univoice do provide an option for that. We have a course called UniPrime for the aspirants that will help you to and through IPM. I'll link it down in the description. Make sure you check it out, and we just have a few more seats left, so make sure you enroll as soon as possible. So these were a few most commonly believed myths about the ITMAT examination. If you've heard anything else that you're not sure if it's true or not, do comment it down below. I or someone from the team will verify it for you. Also, let me know if you need a part 2 of this video, because I think there's still a lot left that needs to be clarified. So if you need that, let me know. I'll be happy to make it for you. And till that time, study well, make sure you like, share and subscribe to the channel. I'll see you soon with another video very soon.